Hello, good afternoon. Yeah, welcome to my YouTube channel. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel if you enjoy what we are doing. Today we are going to talk about a short fish skirt. It's actually a pencil skirt and a flare at the bottom. So yeah, it looks like this. This is the front, and this is, like you can see, it's a pencil skirt at the bottom and has this flare at the lower part. So this is the front of the skirt. This is the back. You can see my imaginary line coming straight, dividing the front of the skirt into two, and the zip line also divides the skirt into two. Also, her waist is 40. You know that we divide the waist by 4. The hip is 52. Divide the hip by 4. The waist to hip measurement, you measure that on the person, and the length of the skirt, we will measure that also on the person. So I'm going to start by drawing my horizontal line like this. This straight edge here is my center line. That's where I'm going to start my measurement from inside. But first, I'm going to measure the length, the waist to hip of the person, of this lady. Her waist to hip is 10. Her length of her skirt is 20. Let me use 27. Plus 1 is in allowance. I did the same thing also here. The length of her skirt is, the waist to hip is 10. The length of her skirt is 27 plus 1 inch. So now I just join the line together like this. Join together like this. Then from the center line here, this first line is the waist. This is the hip. And this is the full length. The full length of the skirt. This is our full length. So here I'm going to make sure our waist, the waist divided by 4. 40 divided by 4, that should give me 10. I'm going to measure 10 here. This is my 10 over here. The hip divided by 4, that is going to give me 13. 52 divided by 4. And I'll measure this hip to the bottom here also. I'll join it together like this. You can see this is our straight skirt, and shape it to the waist, just like this. And at the back also, like I said before, to do the back of the skirt, I'll give a little space at the back, maybe 2 inches or 1 inch or 3 inches, whatever you want. So I'll measure, I'm going to use 2 inches here. Yeah? This is from the back. This is the zip line. From the zip line now, I'm going to measure the waist inside. The waist is 10. A hip is 13 divided by 4. And I'll measure that 13 also at the bottom part of the skirt. Then I'll join both of them together like this. And I'll join this to the waist like this. Now this is a pencil skirt. Now remember, you can see this skirt has a cut somewhere at the knee, here like this. So I'm going to measure the waist to knee of the person. So what I actually measured for this lady was 19. So I'm going to start from this part. I'm going to measure the waist to knee. Let me use 20. I measure 19, but I want to use 20. 20 here like this. And I'll measure 20 at the back also, waist to knee. Then I'll join it together like this. You can see. This is the knee of the person. Now remember, we are doing our pencil skirt like from my previous video. I said at the bottom part of the skirt, can you move 2 inches or 1 inch to have that pencil effect at the bottom? So this is the bottom part here. I'll make sure I'm going to move 2 inches for this lady. I'll join it to the hip straight like this. Join to the hip like this. You can see this is, I've joined it to the hip. You can see the shape of the pencil skirt coming out now. So I raise this for my line off like this. So you can see our pencil skirt like. Now the same thing I'm going to do at the back. I remove 2 inches at the front. Remember from the previous video, I'm going to remove 1.5 at the side here. Remove 1.5 at the side here and join it to the hip. So I have a pencil shape for the back. And at the zip area, at the bottom part, I'm going to move the remaining half inch. We're supposed to make it 2 inch. Join it to the hip here like this. Going to the hip here. So I'm going to raise this up. You can see this pencil skirt. But what we are doing is a short fish skirt with flare at the bottom. That is what we are doing. We are not making a pencil skirt. Now, you can see, now from here to here, from this knee up is this side here. While from this knee down is going to be our flare. So, now this is the knee part. If you look at, this is the knee part here. And it goes inside like this. I'm just going to make it straight out like this. Because we are going to cut out the flare. It's going to come straight down like this. Being pencil at the bottom part here, and at the back also, I'm going to bring it out straight like this. That this part is going to represent the flare at the bottom of the skirt, which is this side here. So I'm going to add my sewing allowance now, 1.5 inch. I use 1.5 inch. 1.5 inch sewing allowance like this. Okay, it's getting a bit different from the normal pencil skirt we did before. Now, we join it like this now. I'm going to add some allowance for the back zip allowance, which is 1 inch here also. See, now this is the front and this is the back. So I'm going to cut out the joining that's supposed to make out for the flare, which is at the knee here, like this. You can see this is the upper part of the skirt and this is the lower part of the skirt, like this. So we are going to create the flare now using this. Now, I want to create my flare now. Now this is the flare part for the front. Now I'm going to indicate the upper part of this flare, which is supposed to be this side. So for me to create a flare now, very easy. Using pattern, I'll just draw out lines on this flare. So I can draw any amount of line. I can draw 4, I can draw 5. It's not composite, they must be equal distance. Just going to, these are 3 lines on my flare. The same thing at the back also. I want to draw some straight lines like this. 3 lines also. I'm also going to indicate the upper part of this flare for the back, which is supposed to be this side here. So for me to create the flare now. Now remember I said this is the up and this is the down. I'm going to cut from the down upward like this. leaving a tiny part at the upper part here. You can see like this. So I'm going to cut the three lines the same way like that. I'm going to do the same thing for the back also. I'm going to cut it like this. You can see a little bit is left at the upper part of the flare, The same thing, I'll cut the three lines like that. You can see them like this. This one I used to create the flare. Remember, this is the center of the skirt. Don't forget to indicate it. Here is the center of the skirt. Here is the center. Now this paper here is going to represent our fabric for now because we are doing pattern. So I'm going to make sure the edge of this paper gets to the edge also here like this. Like this. Then I'll spread it out like this. This is how you create your flare. You can spread it out as much as you want, like this. I don't want my flare to be too big. So you can see that, then I'll trace it out like this. You can see that. Trace it out like this. Then I'll trace it out. This line now. Then show you the piece of paper. You can see the flare coming out like this. This is the center. This is the center here like this. You see the flare. I'll do the same thing for the flare at the back. This was a normal paper where I've cut it out. Then I'm going to spread it out like this. I'll spread it out. This is the zip part. It's going to be equal to the edge here like this. Then I'll spread it out like this. Then I'll trace it out again. So this is now the flare for the bottom part of the skirt. Trace it out like this. And see it now. This is the zip area, I won't forget that. So then I'll cut it out. And that function. So in allowance, you can see the flare now. This is the flare. I'll cut out the back also. I mean the front also. See the flare for the front. You can see it was a straight path. For now, we are turning to the flare. I'm going to cut. So it's going to be something like this. I'm going to place it on the paper. Then I'll cut it out now. I'm going to cut it out. Indicate the back, much always indicate the back so you know where the zip is going to start from. I put a little notch in like this so you won't get it mixed up. Thank you. much is it passing? This is how the front is going to come out. After you finish cutting it, it's going to be like this. This is the front, the upper part, and this is the lower part of the flare. So you can already see it's coming out like this. This side is going to be like this. See the flare at the bottom part, and this is the back also. At the bottom part like this. So thank you for staying with us today. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to our video to get more updates when we post new videos. So do have a nice day. Bye bye.